John, thank you. Well, our parents wanted shoes that lasted, but we want shoes that biodegrade, don't
we? That's absolutely right.
I mean, it's amazing. Susanna Seiger joins us now from Mapetite Shoes in Hamden, and you have some great trends that you want to share with us, starting with eco-friendly footwear.
Well, this is a fantastic company from the West Coast named Simple, and they've been making eco-sneaks.
Cute.
For a number of years, but brand new this year, and it's just in time for Earth Day, is a biodegradable shoe. And so you can see, if you look for all these little worm designs in the bottom of the shoe,
yeah,
and it's stamped with biodegradable, this shoe will actually biodegrade under landfill conditions only within 20 years. And the typical compostability of a shoe to degrade like that is any of these other ones for 1,000 years in a landfill.
1,000 years? Really?
So they've broken it down to 20 years.
That's
so you
amazing.
Still have great wear,
yeah,
for as long as you want it, but as soon as they're ready to go, then they will biodegrade. It's innovative.
Very innovative. I mean, to get that kind of technology from 1,000 years versus 20, and what do these go for, roughly?
They're around $50, $50, $60.
Okay.
And then we also have them for men,
big
which
old
is
clunkers.
Great.
Big old clunkers.
That's the small one.
Yeah, exactly. All right, so you have three trends for spring.
Yes.
Tell me about the first one.
Well, spring is influenced a great deal this year by Alice in Wonderland.
Right.
So these are called our Wonderland shoes.
Yes.
And they are just fabulous colors and beautiful details that
mm-hmm.
almost look like a little
it
piece
does.
Of candy
it looks
on
edible.
The toe.
It does. It looks edible.
And we have shoes fit for a Mad Hatter Tea Party.
That is very
A little
fun.
Glimmer in the heel,
uh-huh.
the cherries.
So this kind of Alice in Wonderland, Johnny Depp sort of fantastical thing going with this first trend.
And people love them. I mean, yeah, someone came in and her, even though it's beginning spring, her toenails, people are just aching for spring this year. So her toenails were this beautiful coral color, and she's like, I'll take them.
Oh, very
They're
fun.
They're perfect.
Okay, so that's the first trend. And what's the next trend?
Well, we have on the other side of super colorful, amazing shoes are very neutral,
uh-huh,
bone colors,
really?
Soft suede,
pretty,
very toned down,
mm-hmm,
natural cork and fibers.
Yeah, that cork
and this
heels.
Beautiful kind of daytime to nighttime heel. No?
I love the one on the end because it's sort of Mary Poppins-y.
Yes, this is fun.
It
is a great
fun.
Dance shoe, great with a suit. And do you like the heel a little bit better?
Yeah, I like that clunky little here. That's very cute.
Mm-hmm. Very very retro
it
and
is.
Vintage
It is, it's fun.
Looking.
It's fun. You said people are buying that kind of shoe for all these dance crazes, dance
there's
classes.
There's kind of this growing group of people, a trend of tango lessons and salsa.
Who knew?
People want to get out there and move and have fun. So you need a shoe that's going to be slippery.
I need a tango shoe. I'm just kidding.
There it is.
And did we get to the third trend? What did you say the third trend was? Did you do that already?
Oh, we have this great heel that is your really chunky,
yeah,
platform heel that has this wedge cut out of it. So look for that in all the fashion trends in the magazines.
Great.
We have it at Mapetite Shoe.
All right, Mapetite Shoe in Hamden, thanks for joining us.
Oh, thanks
Shoes
for having me.
And chocolate. Could there be anything better? Nice to see you, Susanna. Up next.